The A14 Bionic is the fastest A-series Bionic chip that Apple has ever made. And the A14 Bionic also applies to the iPad Air 4. And so this video is my full review of the brand new 2020 iPad Air 4. So, let's get into it. Alright, sup? No best here, and as I said, today is going to be my full review of the iPad Air 4. And so, the iPad is a very familiar thing that we all know, as the iPad has been out for many, many years. But I feel like the iPad Air 4 was the first massive leap for the iPad Air series. The iPad Air 4 is the first generation of the iPad Airs where they have finally taken the flow of all the smartphones and the iPad Pro as getting rid of the home button. As you can see, it is a full screen with little bezels on the sides. So they have gotten rid of the home button, which I really like, but instead of adding Face ID into the iPad Air, they decided to add Touch ID, but the Touch ID is actually built right into the lock button there. So, as you can see, when I push, it says in the top to put my Touch ID there. So, I think that's a cool touch. This is the first time that they've ever incorporated the Touch ID into the lock button rather than having a home button. So this way they can make it unique to the iPad Air and as well bring the cost down that it would cost to put Face ID in from the iPad Pro. Now the iPad Air comes in two different configurations, but between them is a massive leap. You can either choose 64 gigs of storage or 256 gigs of storage. And I feel that they should have added a 128 in the middle in case you don't want to spend too much or you don't have enough storage at 64. So I feel like they should have added that 128 right in the middle, but then it would correlate too much with the iPad Pro because the iPad Pro starts at 128. But I feel that it would have been a nice touch to have the option of 128 as well. Now, no matter what color you get with the iPad Air, they are all sort of this pastel-y color. So they're not fully, this is the sky blue, but it's not fully blue. They're not fully pink, fully green, all that. They're sort of a pastel-y mint kind of color. So the iPad Air comes in space gray, silver, rose gold, green, or sky blue. And they're very colorful options, but again, they are very pastel, very dry color options. So I feel like they should have added more of a color to it. But then again, it is what it is. Now, same as any other iPad, you can choose if you want it just with Wi-Fi or if you want it with Wi-Fi and the option of cellular data with it. So you still have that option, but it is on the iPad Air around an extra $100 and some odd. So you can take your bets there. Now in the box, it comes with your iPad Air 4th generation, a USB-C to USB-C cable because it does charge via USB-C, and a 20-watt USB-C power adapter does come in the box. And I'm sad that I have to specify that it does come in the box because as we all know, the newest iPhones do not come with one in the box. So there you have that. Now, as for accessories, the iPad Air 4 does accept most, if not all, accessories that the iPad Pro accepts. The iPad Air accepts the Magic Keyboard, it accepts the Apple Pencil 2nd generation, and as well, it also has the Smart Folio, which is the one that I have right here, where it can fold into a bunch of different places, and it also still has the Apple logo on the back, if you can see it there. So, I love the Smart Folio, but the Magic Keyboard would be nice to have, but you can have it on the iPad Air 4, just like you have it on the iPad Pro. Now, as for the display, you have a 10.9-inch LED display with a resolution of 2,360 by 1,640 at 264 pixels per inch. The max brightness is 500 nits of brightness, and as I said, it does support Apple Pencil. One thing I love is just like the iPad Pro and the brand new iPhone 12s, the iPad Air has the flat, boxy edge design, which resorts back to the iPhone 5, which I personally think is the best option in any Apple device. So that was a cool touch that they were able to bring that back. As for the camera, you have one camera on the back, which is a 12 megapixel wide angle lens. It has an f1.8 aperture, and as well you have smart HDR built into that 12 megapixel camera. Basically, it is the exact same camera that is on the iPhone XR, I believe. It has 4K video, it has HDR, it has a 12 megapixel with a 1.8 lens aperture, so I feel it's the exact same. On the front, you have the exact same as the XR as well. It is a 7 megapixel front camera with a f2.0 aperture and up to 1080p HD at 60 frames per second, so you don't get that 4K like you do on the iPad Pro. As for microphones, you have two dual microphones for video calling and for audio recording if you are into that as well. The iPad Air 4 has a 9,720 milliamp hour battery, which will give you around 10, maybe more hours of battery life, but if you have the cellular version and you are using data, you'll get around 9 hours of battery life or even less. And of course, you have the beloved, amazing, refreshed iPad OS 14 design. Yeah, so there's not really much new with the iPad Air, as we have seen all of this before in the iPad Pro, but I would say it's sort of a dumbed down version of the iPad Pro. And I feel like the iPad Air is the one option that's going to go to many because of all the features it has that the iPad Pro has, into a version that is more suitable for the everyday use of everyone else. Because at the end of the day, who really needs a 120 hertz display, and who really needs a LiDAR sensor? I feel like only 1 out of 1,000 people use the LiDAR sensor for actual purposes. So yeah, I feel like the iPad Air will be a very, very famous choice for everyone else. Again, you get the Apple Pencil support at the top here. You get your smart connector on the back, which is how I'm able to magnetically connect to this and it won't fall out at all, which is really cool. And so yeah, that is the iPad Air 4 review. So that's been it. Thank you for watching. Please do go out and have a great day, and we shall see you in the next one.